So continuing with the fact that in a lot of data science courses and tutorials you look at, there's a lot of talk about preparing data. One of the other scenarios that you'll often have to handle is handling duplicate rows. You'll see that data science really doesn't like it when there's multiple copies of the same row, and they also tend to get upset or crash, even can crash code, if you encounter rows which have missing values. So let's see how Python and the pandas data frame gives us some methods and techniques for handling those situations. So, and specifically, let's start with the missing values. There are many different data science methods you'll use which will actually crash if they hit a row with missing values. So if I had the data frame here in front of me for some airport information, because I have an arrival time and a delay time that are missing values showing up as that NAN, this could actually cause my code to crash. I won't be able to train a model. So one of the things we need is a way of just knowing if a particular data frame has missing values. And the info method of the data frame is fantastic for this. What it'll do is it'll tell you all sorts of great information. One of the things it'll tell you is how many rows are in your data frame. And then, for each of the columns, it will tell you how many of the rows in that data frame contain values that are not null. So you can see here that the flight date, well, all 300,000 rows contain non-null values. So there are actual values in every single row for the value of flight date and for unique carrier. But wait, when I hit tail number, out of that 300,000 rows, only 299,000 or so of them have actual values, non-null values in them. That means that some of those rows do contain a null or a missing value. So you can see here there's actually three different columns that have a number lower than 300,000 with non-null. So that indicates to me there are some missing values for some of the rows of these three columns. So now that I know I have some missing values, how can I now use Python to deal with those values? Well, fortunately, Python pandas is designed for this, so it has a drop NA method, which means drop NA, those NAN values, and it allows me to remove those rows from my data frame. Now, one thing to be aware of, very specific when working with pandas data frames, when I do a drop NA, I am not actually dropping the rows from the data frame itself. I am saying drop the rows and then copy the data frame with the dropped rows to a new data frame. So here I have this one row with null values. So what it does is it creates a new data frame called delay no nulls data frame, and it's missing that row 2 which had the null values or the missing values. If, however, you want to actually modify the data frame itself, you can do that by just specifying in place equals true, and then what happens is it literally just removes that row from the existing delays DF data frame. The other scenario we might need to handle is duplicate rows. So you will often find that a lot of times when we're working with data science, you'll be given files from multiple different places, and then you combine all those files together into one data frame. And that may mean that you get into situations where sometimes rows may be loaded multiple times. So we also want to handle those duplicate rows because that can skew results when you're doing data science. So here I have some data in front of me and some simple information about airports, but I have two rows for the airport in Dulles, Washington. So how do I handle that using my Python and my Danda and Python and pandas? We have the airport's data frame we call duplicated, and what that will do is it will return true or false for every row. And if a row that it locates is a duplicate of a previous row, then we'll see a true. So you can see here that the first row it returns false, second row is false, because up until now it has not seen a duplicate of Dulles. The next row is another row, it's exactly the same, so now it says true because this row is a duplicate of a previously seen row, and the remaining rows are all false. I also want to make sure we highlight here that it is the entire row that's a duplicate. We have multiple records with a country of USA, but duplicated is looking for records with the entire row is a duplicate. So this allows us to locate duplicate records. Now how do we get rid of them? Well, there's a wonderful little method called drop duplicates. And I'm going to use that same little trick I did for dropping missing rows of missing values. I'm going to use the in place equals true to say within this data frame itself, drop the duplicate rows. And what that's going to simply do for me is get rid of that second row for Dulles, Washington. So my data is all set, nice and tidy, ready for me to go on and play with my data science. So now we've dropped our duplicate rows. We're ready to start going and doing things like training models. Now let's try all of this out in actual code.